Well, from smartwatches to fitness trackers, people use wearable technology for many reasons.
But now a Stanford scientist and her team are using the technology to help boost the art of surgery.
KPIX 5's Juliette Goodrich has tonight's original report.
A lot of big events take place here at the Moscone Center, but this time the spotlight was on a high-tech experiment involving hundreds of doctors.
Inside a prestigious meeting for the American College of Surgeons.
Do you have any watches on right now?
No, nothing.
Downstairs, underground.
Oh my goodness. Wow.
I'm a victim.
Doctors from around the world.
Hi.
Volunteer to participate in an unusual experiment.
And what I'm doing now is being manhandled by these people who are doing some sort of neurocognitive testing.
The task at hand? The future of surgery.
This is a very original thinking.
It's called the Surgical Metrics Project. Here, surgeons underwent a bit of biohacking.
I was curious. I wanted to see what it was all about.
Over the course of 3 days in the exhibit hall, 253 surgeons performed a common operation. But before they picked up their forceps, each doctor was outfitted with a bevy of wearable technologies.
This is definitely not typical operating room attire.
The devices will measure their surgical decision making, as well as their technique as to why.
The goal of this project is really to bring new and fresh data to what we do as surgeons on a daily basis.
The brains behind the operation, Stanford trauma surgeon and educator Dr. Carla Pugh. Digital data is her domain.
It's the future. When you look around us, all of healthcare is now becoming digital. Surgeons need to be part of that conversation.
Pugh is an international expert on the use of sensors and motion tracking technology. She wants to help surgeons by quantifying their experience.
If you want to be the best that you can be, getting there is much easier when you have data.
The experiment begins by measuring a surgeon's brain activity. Technicians attach a wearable EEG to the forehead. The doctor then takes a cognitive test.
We had to do a test of our attention and memory.
The EEG's role
is to get a baseline of the cognitive abilities of the people, and then we want to compare that to their performance during the operation.
The team then puts motion tracking capture sensors on the surgeon's fingers. The hands get gloved and the wires cabled to a control unit.
Once you get into it, you kind of relax and forget that you've got wires on your fingers.
The patient, it's actually a small piece of a pig's intestine punctured with tiny holes.
You may perceive.
The surgeon must first find.
Here's one.
And then repair the damage. They have 20 minutes.
That's perfect.
Two small video cameras record the action as the surgeons work. The sensors capture the surgeon's hands moving in 3D. The EEG sends the doctor's brain waves to the cloud. All sound is recorded and the data synced up.
I was rushing.
When time's up, a photo is taken and water pumped through to see if there are any leaks.
It didn't leak. Woo!
It was perfect.
The data is now waiting to be crunched. The surgeons all see a benefit.
It's very useful in training.
I think it's really important.
There are surgeons that are better than others, but we don't really have any way of checking that.
How do you match up so that you can then improve your skills till you get to the level of the expert?
Or have a way, at least for residents and training physicians, to be able to test our skills.
It's important to make sure that as we age, that there is some kind of true data measurement.
The Surgical Metrics Project will collect more data next year at the Surgeons Convention in Chicago. In San Francisco, Juliette Goodrich, KPIX 5.